After two nights of debates from the 2020 Democratic candidates, it's President Trump's turn to speak to voters, this time with a campaign rally in Cincinnati. Here's what the president said before leaving the White House.
I don't know what's going to happen. I can tell you this. I'm going to Cincinnati. The arena is a very large one, and we've sold it out. We could sell it out probably 10 times from what I hear. The applications for seats, as you know, never had an empty seat. The applications are very big. I have no idea. We have a great group of people. They love our country. They love the job we're doing. And when they see the kind of people that want to represent us from the last two nights, that's not what they want. I don't know. I can't tell you whether or not they're going to do that chant. If they do the chant, we'll have to see what happens. I don't know that you can stop people. I don't know that you can. I mean, we'll see what we can do. I'd prefer that they don't. But if they do it, we'll have to make a decision then.
The president there was referring to last month's rally in North Carolina, where the crowd directed a "send her back" chant at Congresswoman Ilhan Omar. I want to bring in politics reporter for Cleveland.com now, Jeremy Pelzer. He's in Columbus, Ohio. Welcome, Jeremy. Thanks for joining us. So President Trump's rally in Cincinnati is his 60th rally since taking office, his fifth in Ohio. How important is Ohio for President Trump's success in 2020?
Obviously, the Trump campaign seems to think it's pretty important, especially since the vice president, Mike Pence, was here earlier this week. And we expect to see the president here in the Buckeye State many more times, even ahead of the Democratic and Republican primary next March.
So, Jeremy, Democrats just finished 2 days of debates in Detroit, as you know. Do voters feel as if Democrats are taking the Rust Belt more seriously this election cycle?
Well, it's interesting. There was a poll out earlier this week in Ohio, and it actually showed Donald Trump, President Trump, with a negative approval rating. 52% disapproved of him. But at the same time, it's interesting, 58% of Ohioans thought they were better off now than they were in 2016. Mm. And if you ask people here, as well as across the country, they're going to say probably jobs are a big issue for them. And certainly the Trump campaign is hoping that Ohioans will think that the president has brought prosperity to Ohio.
All right. So, Jeremy, Congressman Tim Ryan of Ohio was one of the Democrats on stage Tuesday night in Detroit. He still hasn't qualified for the next round of debate. So what, though, did people think of his performance right there in his home state?
I think, like in Ohio, across the nation, Tim Ryan isn't in the first tier of people, of candidates, when it comes to people's minds. The poll done earlier this week showed Ohioans, even in his home state, only 1% supported Tim Ryan for president. So I think a lot of Ohioans don't even know who Tim Ryan is, and those who don't know who he is, they're supporting other candidates.
That is interesting. Sort of a Bill de Blasio issue, sort of similar here in New York. All right, so what issues do voters in the Great Lakes region on both sides want to hear the candidates and President Trump talk more about?
Well, as I said, one of the big issues, of course, is jobs. And one of the big issues here in Ohio when it comes to jobs is the closure of General Motors' Lordstown auto assembly plant, in which thousands of people lost their jobs. And this was a potential problem for the president, especially because he came in and promised that he would keep those jobs. So obviously the Trump campaign now is trying to come in and say, look, we're, despite the Lordstown closure, we're coming in and we're creating the jobs needed to give prosperity to the state and to the country. So it remains to be seen if Ohioans will trust him on that.
All right. Well, Jeremy Pelzer, we thank you so much for sharing your Ohio insight with us.
Thanks so much.